we're doing a little.
That's not part of it.
That wasn't part of it. And we're doing some improvising. This is actually written for soprano, alto, tenor, and bass. So we are doing some improvising to make it work. And we have Renee, Alyssa, and I'm Jackie, Danny, and Diana. And we are here to have fun today.
We hope you do too. Just a little fun piece.
Wrote the words.
I think that came later, but I don't know how much
later. The entertainer did come from a musical he did that was a flop, and so there may be one somewhere, but I don't think anybody's ever found it.
Okay, because most of his, that kind of music wasn't with singers. I mean, it was in halls and town halls and talk halls and whatnot that, till he went to New York or Chicago someplace.
Well, the music on this particular arrangement says arrangement extra lyrics by Harry Simone.
Okay, okay. Extra lyrics.
Extra lyrics.
Okay.
And I'm not real sure he was from Missouri. He did a lot of his piano work there. You know,
Arkansas tries to claim him too, but
yes.
He was not here very long.
Yes.
Then where do you know where he did most of his composing? Where did he find his niche as far as being?
In the saloons?
Well, I'm thinking about Chicago or New York. You always had to go to a large city to get you a publisher.
St. Louis.
And the thing that we want to keep in mind about that time of music and this the kind of music that he wrote, that a lot of the composers were taking advantage of, and I think he sold them all sometime. I mean, he gave all the rights when he sold them, like for a dollar or something. And he was a prolific writer, and wrote a lot of music that you all have heard his background in movies and whatnot. But I've never heard the words before, and thank you very much. I appreciate that. We all do. And you've given our afternoon a whole new dimension.
You know what, Ragtime and Vaudeville was really campy, and that's why we were so campy and sort of like off the wall, off the charts, you know.
This is how we usually look.
Yeah, but yeah. We usually look this way better.
I'm dressed up for the ball. I want to go to the ball.
And thank you for all your costumes. We don't often get. And thank you for the orchestra. Self-assertive young women and have that great way with five different opinions on how something should be done. Plus, the orchestra conductor says, no, it's all supposed to be done differently. You better do it my way. So it's a cooperative thing that is learned by. What we're hoping to introduce to the school is a collaborative pianist. We're working on a syllabus now to take to the people who decide what the school is going to offer. And part of that is accompanying, which Justine did an example, but also is this business of blending with other voices or instruments and having two soloists or three soloists or four soloists becoming a unit of a one sound, a ensemble sound we call it. But also it's like getting people together at a committee and trying to come to a decision. And the same thing is with musicians, and some musicians who have been very good friends have lost their friendship because they just differed on a tempo or dynamic or whatever. So it is a collaborative effort, and so we don't often have collaborative efforts, so it was extra special hard work for all of you, and so thank you very much. Let's do go on, and if Mr. Donaldson doesn't get here, there's something I want to bring to you all.